Hello and welcome to our Transpennine Trail Langsett Circular Route. The ride today is a mixed bag from rocks to roads, taking in the Transpennine Trail and Langsett reservoirs with the roads joining them all up. We start at the Cote Green Car Park just off Finkel Street Lane. We head up the Transpennine Trail, going through Oxbring and Penistone. We continue on at the first road crossing but exit at the second one near Millhouse Green. We follow these quiet lanes around until we find a bridle path on our left. We follow this pack horse trail, quickly rejoining a road and enjoying a rapid descent. After another short stretch on the road, we find another bridle path on our right. This leads us down to the woodlands around the Langsett Reservoir. We make our way through the woodlands, working our way down to the river and looking for the Cote Gate path. We follow Cote Gate up over the moors. Where the path forks, we head left, following the trail down to Upper Midhope. From Upper Midhope, we enjoy some quiet country lane. The terrain is quite undulating here, but mostly down. Once we reach the junction with Mortimer Road, we turn right and then take our first left onto Oaks Lane. Just before a steep climb on Oaks Lane, you should see an entrance into Underbank Reservoir. Go down there. Follow the trail around the reservoir anti-clockwise until you rejoin Clay Pits Lane. Follow Clay Pits Lane around until you join Manchester Road. This is the main road that will take you through Stocksbridge and Deepcar, and aiming us back to Finkel Street. Follow the road around until you can get onto Sawley Lane, and then it's one straight lane straight back to Finkel Street and the entrance to the Transpennine Trail. Here we are on the Transpennine Trail. I'm just about to approach the first road crossing. At this one, continue straight on, obviously look out for traffic, although rare it does come down this lane. Here is the second road crossing, it's at Millhouse Green on the map. This is the one we take, we'll take a right and head down the lane. Just go down the lane to Millhouse Green. bear left at the junction and continue up the hill. Continue over the bridge which goes over the Transpennine Trail. Follow the lane up until you see a bridle path on your left. The entrance to the bridle path is just here on our left. After severe weather, sometimes this path can get a little bit flooded. Usually there's a way of getting round or riding through it anyway. Continue on until you get to this junction, then turn right and head up the hill towards the road. This track can be quite an interesting ascent at times. After heavy rain, it can often become a river. Once the climb is over, you go right on the road and you get quite a nice descent down to the next junction. After you descend, you need to stop at this junction here and turn left. After a short stint on the road, we'll see a bridle path to our right. This one will take us down to Langsett Reservoir. At the end of the bridle path there is a quick descent which will take you down to the main road. Cross over the main road and go straight into the woodland. After entering the woodlands at Langsett, we'll go down this path and then take the first right. At the next junction, we'll take a left and head down towards the river. You'll probably be approaching the next junction at speed. Bear left here. At the final junction before the river, you'll need to bear right and get ready for a steep descent over cobblestones. Although it may not have looked so steep as I rode down it, this is what it looks like from the bottom. Taking a left at the bridge, we go through this gate and up to Cote Gate Path. This will take us over the moors. Ready for our next section? At this first junction, we take a left and have a quite rapid descent down to Midhome. You'll have to excuse the mud on the lens. At this point, I didn't notice it, and Sarah's camera didn't record this section. He would climb up the hill to Upper Midhope. After passing through the village, take a right at this junction. Here we follow quiet lanes over undulating terrain, down to the mustard pot at Midhope Stones. At the junction with Mortimer Road, turn right and then your first left. After a couple of miles, you'll notice the entrance to Underbank Reservoir, which is what you can see us entering now. Following the path, go anti-clockwise around the reservoir until you meet up with the road again. Once you reach the road, go through the gate and then go down the hill. Follow the road around until you meet up with the main road. This is the junction with the main road, or Manchester Road. Go right here and go through Stocksbridge and Deepcar. Here we are approaching the main junction in Deepcar. Once you get to the lights, take a left, follow the road around and over the bridge. Once you've gone under the railway bridge, continue round. Ignore the first exit on your left, but take the second. This is where you take the second exit. It's onto Sawley Lane and this will take you back into Finkel Street. As I said at the beginning of the video, this route is quite mixed. It's got some off-road work along the Transpennine Trail, some rougher stuff around the reservoir at Langsett, and it's got some road work joining it all up. As such, it might not be for everyone, but let's get to the scores. For time taken, I awarded this route 3 wheels. It will take between 2.5 and 3.5 hours. However, if you want to push yourself, I'm sure you can do it much faster. The distance is around 20 miles, so we awarded the TPT Langsett Circular 2 wheels out of 5. The terrain is mixed with various surfaces and gradients to tackle. We awarded this route 3 wheels. The technical aspects of this ride vary throughout its length. As such, we awarded it 3 wheels out of 5. Overall, I awarded this route 3 wheels out of 5. It's a great ride with mixed disciplines for those that enjoy both on and off-road riding. We feel it is a ride we will do again in the near future. If you enjoyed the video, please feel free to like and share. If you have any questions, use the comments section below. If you want to see more of our cycle routes, then please subscribe. If you'd like to see another video straight away, we have a selection on the screen for you now. We have the Rother Valley to Tapton Lock video, a video we shot at Sherwood Pines while doing the Blue Route, and a trip up the Transpennine Trail that's mentioned in this video up the Don Valley. Until next time, stay safe on the trails and thanks for watching.